Hi, this is Alyssa again. I am here at AS220, and we are going to be speaking with artist Lois Harada. And I'm going to turn around and show you the opening of her work. So the title of her show is I Had Other Plans, and it's up from April 3rd through the 24th. And if you notice at the bottom there, she has her letterpress type pieces on the frame, which I think is a really great detail. So we're going to go inside to the gallery. I'm going to hand the microphone over to Lois.
Hi, Alyssa. Hi, everyone. Let me know if my volume is too loud. Okay, great. So welcome to the Aborn Gallery at AS220. 95 Empire Street. Right now the gallery is closed, so you need to make an appointment if you want to come in person, and you do that by emailing Neil Walsh. And Neil is actually behind Alyssa, so I'm making awkward eye contact with Neil. And I have a few different pieces in the show, so I'd love to start with the piece right behind me, which is called Tally. And we'll slowly get closer, or I'll follow Alyssa's lead as she's cameraing. So this piece is a visual representation of all of the deaths in Rhode Island attributed to COVID-19. So as we get closer, you'll be able to see that each piece of paper has a number on it. And for me, as a way to think about COVID and the actual, you know, physical toll that it's taken on our community, I wanted to find a way to visualize the total numbers of people that we've lost. So each slip of paper is a number that's ascending. So it starts with one actually outside on the street, and then it goes all the way up to the current count as of last Saturday, which was 2,638. And I'm actually updating the count every week. So this piece is a good representation of my work because it's using the commercial form of letterpress printing. You know, something like numbering is very commonly used commercially, but less so in a fine art setting. So I think the color of the paper too, you know, red kind of signifies something is important or an alert. So pairing that with the numbers and hanging all of the tags, I think, is a good visual impact. And it's been a meditative piece to make and install because I had some helpers help me actually hang each piece of paper number by number. But also for visitors and talking to guests, you know, it's been a moment for them to also breathe and take a minute to sort of process everything that's happening. So we're gonna spin this way. So in also thinking about the pandemic, I've been getting stuck in a lot of loops. So, you know, as I've been stressed out or thinking about the news, I've been sort of in these emotional loops, and so I wanted to actually set some type that was in a circle so that it sort of represented the different patterns that I've been feeling stuck in. I wish I had put one in for procrastination, because that's also something that I've really been experiencing. And as Alyssa mentioned earlier, the show is called I Had Other Plans, and I did have some other plans for this exhibition. But, you know, having pieces that were a response to the pandemic felt very important to me. And also some of the work is about anti-Asian sentiment and xenophobia. And so because the attacks happened in Georgia just a few weeks before I was set to install, I wanted to make some pieces that were really reflective of that. So outside in the windows, there's a big poster installation of Stop Asian Hate posters, as well as some other pieces. And the piece that Alyssa started with is also rather recent and made sort of in that same sentiment. If we head this away, so this piece is called Signals, and it's a collection of 26 letterpress prints that are based on nautical signal flags. So especially around the pandemic, I've been thinking about nonverbal forms of communication, partly because, you know, as we're all wearing masks, I'm always worried that people aren't understanding me and that I'm not understanding people. So it's been interesting to think about different forms of nonverbal communication. And also this relates back to thinking to last year's election with misinformation and fake news, which is still happening with the pandemic and as the vaccines roll out. So for me, a lot of times people don't think of solids as a good fit for letterpress printing, but I'm lucky to work at DWRI Letterpress, which is a commercial print shop just barely on the west side of town. And so I was able to use the presses and the resources there to create these works. Each print also has the meaning of the letter. So right now I think you're zooming in on Q. So you can actually see the letter and what the flag means. So out of context, some of them are pretty interesting. The letter K is I wish to communicate with you, which I think, you know, is a good sentiment during the pandemic. And U is we are moving into danger. So I liked the idea of putting the letter that the flag represents after it. It sort of felt like a letter or a note. So this piece has been really fun to work on because it is such a bold graphic statement, but then you get to come a little closer and see some of the actual meanings of the flags. And the one in the corner is the letter A. I think I was challenging to hang for Neil because the grid is 25 letters over here, and then the 26th letter A starts over in the corner. So these are all an addition of 25 prints, meaning I have 25 of each letter, and I'll plan to sell a few letters individually, but most of the letters as sets. And if we walk into the other corner of the gallery, I actually have some of the letters combined. So on their own, the letters mean one thing, but grouped together, they mean something else. So here, the letters Z and L means your signal has been received but not understood. So there's a whole dictionary and phrase book of these flags. And you know, traditionally your ship would have had somebody to manage and hang the flags because this is how you would have communicated with other boats. So it's kind of an interesting thing to think about these actually being a practical object, whereas here, you know, as a printed form, they're transformed into something different. And I thought the groupings were interesting, just it's kind of a nice graphic breakup in the show too. So I guess let's spin back to the other corner, if that makes sense. You guys, Alyssa's doing an amazing job. I don't think that I can handle this camera work. So in the corner, I have a piece that I completed in 2020, and it's based on the novel Parable of the Talents by Octavia Butler. And I was really thinking about the election, which this piece was created before. And the book is the second in a series of sort of a post-apocalyptic world. But the political landscape was very similar to, you know, what it was in the Trump administration. And I think in pairing this piece with the count piece for COVID with Tally, it really was a way to connect the xenophobia that came out of the Trump administration with this current spate of anti-racist attacks. So, you know, the language of Kung Flu, the China virus, it really elevated and emboldened a lot of people to use some of that more hurtful language. And as somebody of Japanese American descent who's often used that identity as part of my work, I really wanted to figure out a response to that feeling, to that sentiment that I could put in the show. Great. So that's an overview of the work. Outside, there's also more of these counting pieces and also that installation of posters. The show is going to be up through April 24th, so you'll be able to make an appointment to visit on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays with Neil Walsh. And I'm here most Saturdays, so if you want to come in and talk to me about the work and see it in person, I'd love to visit with you on Saturdays. Great.
Lois, thank you so much. Thank you very much. I definitely learned a lot here, and it's actually interesting because it's Gallery Night's 25th anniversary season, so I love, you know, I'm attracted to anything with 25s at this point. So, and I also love how you took the letter A out of the grid. Normally, I think, like, I would think logically somebody would do a Z, so I find it fascinating that you chose, like, the beginning, kind of like as the statement, like the beginning punctuation instead of the end. So, fantastic exhibit. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. We will be back in a few with our next stop.